Hello everyone and welcome back, and now we are going to take a look at the pterygoid processes of the sphenoid. So here you can see the two pterygoid processes of the sphenoid, each consisting of a lateral pterygoid plate and a medial pterygoid plate. And between these pterygoid plates you can see this gap. This is the pterygoid fissure when viewed from front, and from behind the gap is still more. Between these two plates you have the pterygoid fossa. Now anterior to these pterygoid plates, over here you had the maxilla. So between the maxilla and the pterygoid process you have the gap of the pterygopalatine fossa, into which will open these small openings. Now these openings are, the lateral one is the foramen rotundum, which gives passage to the maxillary nerve, and then you have the pterygoid canal, which will give passage to the vessels and nerve of the pterygoid canal, and further medially you have the palatovaginal canal or pharyngeal canal, through which will pass the pharyngeal vessels and nerves. So this is the lateral surface of the lateral pterygoid plate, this is the medial surface of the medial pterygoid plate, and anteriorly to the lateral, anterior border of the lateral pterygoid plate, you have the attachment of the maxilla. So if you look at this picture, the maxilla is somewhere here, and to the anterior border of the lateral pterygoid plate is attached the maxilla below, and above there is a gap. This gap is the pterygomaxillary fissure, through which the maxillary artery will enter the pterygopalatine fossa. So if we look at the sphenoid from behind, the look is a bit clearer. So this is the lateral pterygoid plate, medial pterygoid plate. This lateral pterygoid plate has got an anterior border, and over here it has got a posterior border. The posterior border is more or less free. The anterior border is attached below to the maxilla. And this lateral pterygoid plate, it has got a lateral surface, it has got a medial surface. And to the lateral surface, you have the attachment of the, to this lateral surface, you have the attachment of the lower head of the lateral pterygoid. This lateral pterygoid muscle has got an upper head and it has got a lower head. The upper head is attached here to the infratemporal surface of the greater wing of the sphenoid, and here is the lower head of the lateral pterygoid. And to the medial surface is attached the deep head, or the principal attachment of the medial pterygoid muscle. And to this posterior border, again, you have the attachment of the pterygospinous ligament from the spine of the sphenoid. And this gap is the pterygoid fossa. And this smaller gap, the pterygoid fissure, is actually filled up by the pyramidal process of the palatine bone. Now, if you look at this medial pterygoid plate, it also has anterior border, posterior border, lateral surface, and a medial surface. The anterior border is actually adherent to the perpendicular plate of the palatine bone. So the perpendicular plate of the palatine bone is attached here, and the rest of the medial surface here forms the wall of the posterior part of the nasal cavity. So the posterior nasal cavity is here, and the posterior nasal opening is at the posterior border of the medial pterygoid. Now if you look at the upper aspect of the posterior border, you can make out that the posterior border opens up here into a space. This is called the scaphoid fossa, and this scaphoid fossa gives the main attachment to tensor valley palatini muscle, which was being attached to the spine also, spine and along this margin, and it takes up, it expands and takes up a major attachment over here to the scaphoid fossa. From here it becomes tendinous, descends and hooks around the pterygoid hamulus. So this hook-like process over here is the pterygoid hamulus, and there is a groove behind it. So the tendon of the tensor valley palatini passes through this groove and then comes and enters the soft palate, expanding as the palatine aponeurosis. So the posterior border, it expands up into the scaphoid fossa. In the middle there is a secondary elevation, the processus tuberius, which gives support to the auditory tube. That auditory tube which passed medial to the spine of the sphenoid was supported by this small elevation over here. This is the auditory tube, and the tendon will pass along the lateral surface and hook around the pterygoid hamulus. Now the hamulus itself gives attachment to something called the pterygomandibular raphe. From the hamulus going on to the mandible, behind the third molar tooth is the pterygomandibular raphe, and to the anterior part of that raphe is attached the buccinator muscle, and to the posterior side of that raphe is attached the superior constrictor muscle. So the superior constrictor muscle also takes its partial attachment from the pterygoid hamulus and with its covering fascia as well, that is the buccopharyngeal fascia and the pharyngobasilar fascia. So all these things you have to remember about the lateral and medial pterygoid plates, the attachment of the lateral pterygoid muscle, medial pterygoid muscle, tensor veli palatini muscle, the hooking of the pterygoid hamulus, the attachment of the superior constrictor muscle, the support given to the auditory tube, the articulation with the perpendicular plate of the palatine bone, and the pyramidal process of the palatine bone over here in this gap here. All these things you have to keep in mind. Thank you.